next question is of similar kind. So what is the difference between this radio regulatory service and the ITS service?
Indian regulatory radio regulatory services is a new service. I think it has only started 3-4 years back, and it is made to fill the vacancies of Wireless Planning Commission. So it is an office under the Department of Telecom only, but it has different roles than ITS. So their officers are recruited to IRRS. But IRRS and ITS have totally different job.
Sir, what are the daily challenges you face in this service?
See, there are as such no responsibilities in classroom training. Mm. Only you have to grasp the knowledge provided by the lecturers and faculty. But when you go to field, you have to handle various inspections and audits in association with telecom service providers, and you can do inspections with your own staff only. So there you have to be aware of all the license agreements, you have to be aware of the rules and regulations so that you can perform your duties correctly. And challenge in ITS is that it is a technology service. So you have to be updated with all the current trends and technologies of today's times. And so that when you are in a place to make policies, you make such policies that our regulations, Indian regulations, are in sync with the international developments. And also you have to handle your staff very skillfully so that you get your work done, and you have to motivate them regularly.
Sir, what are the deputation policies regarding this job?
See, there is a very good chance of deputation in ITS because our 300 officers are in deputation, and there is no ministry where an ITS officer is not there. Or in almost every ministry under the government of India, there is at least one ITS officer, whether it be Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Home Affairs, CBI, or even in state governments, ITS officers are in deputation. For example, in Odisha, Special Secretary of Ministry of IT is ITS officer.
Okay. Sir, what are the promotion aspects for this service? Means up to what level you can go?
See, promotional aspects are very good in ITS at present time, because there was a Cadre review in 2017, and after that we have an apex level post of DG Telecom, that is a secretary level post, and then below that there are 8 advisor level post, that is HAG plus. So the promotional aspects are very good. Even I can reach the top and remain there for 2-3 years.
Sir, aspirants also wants to know about what are the facilities regarding this higher education. If someone wants to do to pursue PhD or M.Tech in this service, what are the facilities provided by this your department?
Many people have gone to do higher education, and many times the department supports them if the higher education will benefit the department. Then they will be on a pay. But otherwise also they can go for higher education. They will be provided extraordinary leaves, and they have to manage on their own. They will not be paid for that.
Okay, so you are saying that leave will be allowed?
Yes.
Only their sponsorship will not be allowed?
No, if the department will sponsor in some cases, and in some cases you have to do it on your own.
Sir, what are the pros and cons of this service?
It's a difficult question, but see, every service has its pros and cons. And here the positive things are that you get good working locations. Like our field units are in state capitals. So wherever you will go, you will get good cities, the capitals of the state. So working city is very good. Then the best part is the work-life balance. There is optimum level of pressure. Work pressure, which is necessary also in order to have a meaning in your job. So work-life balance, and then there are many chances of going abroad if you are really working good. So you have a plethora of chances of deputation also. Our offices are doing very good in deputation in various ministries, and you have this 5 days working week. So there are 2 days off, as in all central civil services. So you can have a good weekend. You can spend your time with your family also. So that's a good thing about ITS. And if I talk about the cons, ITS is a central government service, so it is a transferable job. You can remain at a posting for few years, and after that you may be transferred. So that can be taken as a negative, but it is also for people who want to visit new places, it can also be a good thing also. There is not much public interface. That public interface is very less. When you go to EMR audit, you have some public interface, and customer grievance redressal mechanism is also there. So there also you can interact with the public, but not much interaction is there, as in administrative jobs like IES and IPS.
What should be the basis on which an aspirant should decide his preference in DAF?
See, first of all, you have to put group A jobs on the top and group B below. Then you have to understand the profile of each job. Like I'm talking about ITS service. So whoever is watching this will get to know about ITS a lot, and you have to fill the preference as per your own interests, and you only know about your own personality. Whatever the job suits you, you must fill on top in that order. And from my personal opinion is that railway services and ITS should be on top. Railway and ITS are all over India. So, but ITS is in state capitals only, so they can see working locations, then they can see the work-life balance also. Then some people are interested in technical things and research activities, so ITS will be a good option for them. Some people are in want to handle a large number of staff, so they will opt for railway. So depends on working location, the kind of work you are doing.
Sir, what are the facilities given to you as an ITS officer?
See, there is no facilities, but all the things are necessities. Like if you are an IES officer also, you will get a security because you have to, you have a threat to your life.
Right.
So the necessity makes your facility. And some facilities are given to you that are inherent to the department. Like in railway, you will get railway passes. In ITS, you will get this postpaid service connection of BSNL. So that will have unlimited internet and unlimited voice calls. So other than that, if you go to the field units, you will get official car also for inspection and audit purpose. So whatever necessary things are there, the government will provide that. Posting in good locations is also a facility, according to me. And when you are in probation, as an ADD, you get to meet various highest dignitaries like President of India and Vice President of India, and many higher dignitaries. So,
sir, anything you would like to share with aspirants, any advice you want to give to them?
Clearing engineering services examination is not a big deal. You can crack it by studying 8 to 10 months. But this study should be done in isolation. We should not be distracted by other things. So you need such an environment where you can study quietly. And you have to focus on previous year papers, because these papers are the key to the mind of the examiners. So focus on these previous year papers, get to know about what topics are frequently asked. And engineering service examination is all about the width, not much depth. So you have to cover the syllabus as much as possible. Another thing is practice. You have to practice a lot, and that's how you will increase your speed. And when you do a lot of practice and you give some mock tests and prepare yourself better, you will be you will do very well in your exams. You will definitely clear it. And one more thing, you will face a lot of challenges in your preparation phase. There will be ups and downs, you will get demotivated at times, but this is a normal thing. Every aspirant faces these problems. The main thing is that you have to stand up every time you fall and just face the difficulty. Just practice, just don't leave your practice. In 10-11 days, one time you will get demotivated, and so take rest and relax properly, and then again come back to study, and never stop until you achieve your goal, that is cracking the ESE examination. And definitely you will crack the exam if you will try by your heart. And there is one saying that if you do something by your heart, even God comes to help. So I wish you best of luck for your future exam. Just go to the exam hall with confidence, be calm, and you will definitely do very well.
I would like to thank Ankit ji for covering each and every aspect of this service, and I would like to thank our viewers also for watching this video full. Please subscribe this channel Decoding IES for more videos like this, and please comment your queries and suggestions. Thank you. Thank you, sir.